In this video, we're computing the integral of 1 over x squared times x plus 1. So we see this rational integrand and we immediately think partial fractions decomposition. So we're going to start with a partial fractions proposal. And the proposal is that this complicated rational expression breaks down into a sum of simpler fractions. Now we can look at that x squared piece as a repeated linear factor. So we can say that our proposal has to include an a over x and a b over x squared. Now it's totally equivalent to interpret the x squared as a single quadratic factor, and then you would propose ax plus b divided by x squared, and that's totally equivalent if you want to take that approach. Finally, we need a c over x plus 1 to handle that linear factor of x plus 1. So now we're going to clear our denominators as we start looking for these constants a, b, and c. So we multiply by the least common denominator, that's x squared times x plus 1. And when we distribute that to the left-hand side, we're left with just a 1. When we distribute to the a containing term, we end up with a times x plus 1, because one of the factors of x cancels. And then in the b containing term, we have b times x plus 1, because the x squared cancels. And then in the c containing term, the x plus 1 cancels, leaving us with cx squared. Now, because this equation has to be true for all values of x, we're allowed to sub in any value of x we want. So substitution is going to be the most efficient way to get started here. So we're going to start by subbing in x equals 0. And the left-hand side of the equation stays the same. That's just the number 1. And when we sub in x equals 0, the a and c terms are going to vanish. And this just leaves us with b times 0 plus 1, which is just b times 1, or b. So we immediately get b out of this. B is equal to 1. Next, we're going to sub in x equals negative 1. And the point there is that it causes the a and b terms to vanish, leaving us with only the c term. So we have 1 equals c times negative 1 squared, which is just 1. So we discovered that c is equal to 1 as well. So we're done finding useful substitutions, and now we're going to have to switch to the technique of comparing coefficients of different powers of x on the left and right sides of the equation. And x squared will work just fine for this. And again, the reasoning here is that if this equation is true for all values of x, then the coefficient of each power of x must be the same on the left side of the equation and the right side of the equation. Well, on the left side, the coefficient of x squared is 0 because there's no x squareds over there. On the right side, we have an ax squared when we distribute this x into the parentheses. So I end up with an ax squared. And then we also have a cx squared. This means that a plus c must be equal to 0. But with c being equal to 1, we immediately find out a is equal to negative 1. So we've solved our partial fractions decomposition, and now the point is to replace our integrand with this decomposition in terms of three simpler fractions. So now our integral becomes the integral of negative 1 over x plus 1 over x squared, because b is equal to 1, plus 1 over x plus 1, because c is equal to 1. And each of these pieces has a simple antiderivative. In our first piece, we end up with negative natural log absolute value of x. In our second piece, the way to think about this is that we're integrating x to the negative 2, which integrates to x to the negative 1 over negative 1. Or we could write that as negative 1 over x. And in our third piece, we have the natural log of the absolute value of x plus 1. And it's an indefinite integral, so we have a plus c tacked on. Now, just to clean things up a little, we can use log properties to combine negative natural log absolute value of x and natural log absolute value x plus 1. The difference of two natural logs is the natural log of the quotient. So we end up with natural log absolute value x plus 1, that's the first term in our difference, divided by x. Then we have minus 1 over x and plus c, and we're done.
If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.